Hello YouTube, and welcome back to another episode of Trunks Plays Minecraft. Today we have a fabulous, fun-filled building adventure for you all today. You may notice some distinct differences with the way the world appears with us today. Good news is, I got a new PC. So we have a brand spanking new PC that is now capable of handling the Sfax add-on pack for Resonant Rise. So I'm going to mess around with this for a while, see how I like it. I may try out a couple other texture packs, see what I prefer more. But you know, this is looking good for now, so I'm going to stick with it until I get bored of it. So today I want to set up an enhanced portals network using these guys. I've been off over here. This is the beginnings of my bee base. I tend to do bees on most worlds that I play around with, and while I won't do a lot of it on camera, I did kind of want to capture the whole setting up, some of the supporting stuff for bees, and also setting up the enhanced portals network, because you know, portals are cool. Everyone likes portals. You know, what's not to like about portals? So what we need is we need a dimensional bridge stabilizer, we need some portal frames and a portal controller. And we're also going to need a dialing device and some location cards and a wrench. So let's get to it. Dimensional bridge stabilizer. So iron blocks, diamonds, 6, and it's a 2x3x2. So iron blocks, give me a stack of iron. I'm gonna take 3 of you. Stack ender pearls. Yeah, that should be enough. Okay, so need 3 iron and a nether quartz. May as well make that now, because none of the other wrenches seem to work properly with enhanced portals 3 stuff, or at least they didn't last time I messed around with them. So just to be on the safe side, we will make an enhanced portals 3 wrench. I should also make some location cards while I'm here. Make those paper or blue dye. Iron. Okay. Paper. What does that make? 16. That should be plenty. One, so that's 2. Blue dye. Do I have blue dye? I have plenty of blue dye. And some more iron. Cards. Done. I'm just gonna put that stuff that goes in there. Iron goes back there. I need to set up a reed farm. I should have done that already. Anyway. Now, enhanced portals 3 require power. They take redstone flux, which is generated by thermal expansion, so I thought I would extend this line out a little bit. And I would just build onto the end of this. Ta-da! There we go. now we do is we drop the location cards in there. That sets the location, so they are now linked to this dimensional bridge stabilizer. Now it's only two layers thick, so I can only have two active portals at any one time, but that should be more than enough for my purposes right now. I really don't see myself having more than two portals open any time ever. So now we need to make some portal frames. So stone, iron, and quartz blocks. How much stone have I got? That's a whack. So I need two portals, which is 14 blocks each. Something like that. Those quartz blocks or anything, I'd rather store everything like that. May as well put stone back, put another stack of cobblestone in to smelt. And I actually don't know where to put them. Oh wait, hang on. I'll put them upstairs. So that is the basic portal frame outlaid. Now, I said earlier that we needed a portal controller, which we do. So that's a frame and a diamond, and we need a dialing device, which is a network interface and a diamond. Okay, that's cool. I can dig that. So we had 52. Two ender pearls, I'm going to need four diamonds. Three, four. That was five. Oh no, four. Cool. So, two portal controllers, two network interfaces, which then becomes two dialing devices. Four redstone interfaces. Right, now one other thing. I need to make a sticky repeater. I need to make redstone paste, which is slime and a redstone. So I need four pieces of redstone paste, which is cool because that's just that. This will become very clear soon-ish. That's a repeater, which is three stone, two redstone torches. So I need two of those. One, two, three, four. And still have at least six stone. I've only got three. Okay, I'll pull it out of the furnace. Redstone torches. Done. Two. repeater again. Find you in there. You may as well go in there as well because I'm not going to need you. Put the rest of the stuff back. Okay. So now what we do is we go back up here. We replace one of these blocks with, place one of these blocks with the portal controller, place one with the dialing device, and then if we go up here, I don't actually need a sticky one for this, but usually I would do this on the underside of the portal so you can't see it, but so that way, that and that, so that, put that up, and it's facing that way, so this one becomes output, touch portal, input, destroy. And then we right click that, that will initialize the portal. And then you click on a location card into it. Do that. It's not an issue. No, those are torches. I don't want torches. Where are my portal blocks gone? Stop trying to be helpful, inventory tweaks. No, those are still torches. The server. No, the chocobos are still making noise. They're still moving. The server's still alive. Just prodigious lag. Oh, they seem to be back now. Okay. Yay! So now I can right click on this and I can set a unique identifier. So home is going to be cake. So I could try and dial that, but I can't dial the portal that I'm dialing from, which you know makes perfect sense. So now that we've got that set up, to go back out to our little bee base So this is going to be the main bee room, this one here, the big one, and this is going to be the supporting structures room thingy. So I'm just going to redstone. Sticky thing, set that to max delay. That on, put that on. Okay. Click that. Let's set this to name tag. And in here we will put cake, we'll add this, and we will call this home. So now if I dial that, see, I'm back home. So name tag, add that, and we will call this bbase. So now that I've got that done, I can freely come and go from the bee base, which is pretty epic because it means I don't have to cart around all the crap that I need. I can just hop backwards and forwards. So now I need to make me a chunk loader. Chunk. Two words. So 5 gold, an enchantment table, and an ender pearl. Oops. No, just wanted one, thanks. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And let's do one of the enchantment tables. Okay, the other thing I want to build is, and I've started it here, I want to build a cloak oven. The reason I want to build a cloak oven is because you can now use creosote to make impregnated sticks. 18 plus what, 8? So I need more sand. Yeah, you can now use creosote oil to make impregnated sticks instead of having to use seed oil. So if I make a coke oven, then we can get creosote all up and running. And then I still need to make a carpenter as well. So starting casing, which is bronze, so I need bronze. Okay, I've got some bronze. Is that all the bronze I've got? Okay, I'm gonna make bronze. don't. That was incredibly stupid. I've just made twice as much as I need. Oh well. I'm sure I'll need another carpenter at some point. So I don't really want to mess around with power, so I'm gonna make a clockwork engine. Because I don't need to make the carpenter doesn't need to make be on all the time. So there's glass, a piston, some wood, copper gear. Which is copper and a stone gear. Should be stone gears near somewhere. One stone gear. 1, 2, 3, 4. Copper. Copper gear. There should be clocks somewhere. Clocks and piston should be in here. Some wood, not an issue. And a bit of glass. Glass, glass, glass. There we go. There we go. One clockwork engine. I changed up this a little bit as well, so I'm now abusing the nether lava for power, mainly because it's something I've never done before. It should also be that way around. So I thought I'd give it a shot. I changed these so that the pulverizers now output into the item darts, which go to the redstone furnaces. There's probably actually stuff sitting in these. So yeah, changed that a little bit. This is still pouring ingots, it's only 6. Copper, no, stop. Okay, we'll come back. So I've now got heaps of all the metal or gears. I got bored one night, so I went mining in the nether. So I've now got all these ores to deal with. You're finished. Okay, so let's make me some more coke oven blocks. 24. 18 plus 8 is 36. Need more. I'm right out of sand, man. It's not cool. Okay, now the bronze should be all nice and mixed now. I hope. Bronze molten. Should be mixed. I don't know. Confused. This is also confusing. Anyway, I've got 6 bronze ingots. I can shove that back on. You can make more bronze ingots. So yeah, I'm just going to start firing for wood into the coke oven. That'll make me me charcoal and it made me chrysolite. I just wanted to double check that it did definitely make chrysolite. Otherwise it would have been kind of pointless. Okay, so now we can make a carpenter. So we need a sturdy frame thingamabob. Desert over here. That I've kind of already decimated slightly. Connect and reconnect, so I'm going to cut cam quickly and then I'll be back. Okay, so I am back. No idea what was going on there. Disconnected, yeah, everything's fine, cool. We're back in business. So let's just annihilate some more of this desert, oasis, whatevs. It's got sand, I need sand. Last time I was here, my charcoal died, suffocated in quicksand. Would also help. Yeah, that should be enough sound to last me for. Well, I say it should be enough sand, but I thought the last batch of like 10 stacks I thought was enough. Need a repair. Okay. So, 39. Let's grab me another stack of sand. Let's make me some more coke blocks. 9. I think we're up to Three more, man. Come on, three more. Who? What the? Why do I have two barrels of coal? That is what they call crazy talk. Back to the bee base. So we are going to set up the coal cavern, we're going to set up the carpenter, and then we are going to call it day. Because I'm probably bored you enough. Where am I? This is not the bee base. Must be issues. I'm gonna have to check the server logs. Fear not, fearless traveller. We can fly. Probably take just about as long getting there by flight anyway. First things first. Coco then. Oh, not again. Seriously? Stop fanning around Minecraft. Okay, up here. And there we go. So we have a coal coven. I'm gonna just drop a fluid auction between there to take out the grizzle. I'll bring over some wood, chuck it in a chest somewhere, just feed it in as we need be. Clockwork engine, basically you right click until that, and then you let go, and it should start generating power. Like so. So that's cool. What I'll also do is I will. I'm gonna have to replace all this cherry wood. It doesn't matter. Yeah, I will put a layer of. Actually, no, I don't. Yeah, I'll fix it up so that we can breed bees here. I'll set up some apiaries. This will probably be the last that you see of this base unless I get any sort of real cool bees. Because I don't really want to bore people overly much. But yep, thank you guys all for watching. If you enjoyed the video, if you want to see some more, please leave me a like or a comment. If there's something in specific that you want me to do, something you want me to cover, please comment below and I will see what I can do for you. Bye bye for now, guys.